Welcome Dreamers and Simmers, I'm Sam from Ugly Sofa Gaming and today I'm building my own home in The Sims 4 and Dreams. Both are PS4 games but the gameplay will be recorded using a PlayStation 5. I've been a Sims player for the longest time, owning so many copies and versions of on PlayStation, Wii and even DS, so I'm a big fan of the build mode and the game in general. If you're a fan of the channel, you'll know that we're also big Dreams fans here and are creating in Dreams more and more. And so I wanted to do a bit of a comparison. I am going to make my own home in both games, comparing the time it takes, the accuracy of the room, and looking a bit at the overall cost based on the assets used. Keep your eyes peeled. We will be asking you to judge which version of the house you think is best at the end. Setting up in Henford-on-Bagley, I've decided to start by building my living room. Oh, and a disclaimer to cover the shame. Me and Nee work full time, and in our spare time tend to be working on this channel, so the house is not 100% how we would like it, as we just don't have any time left over. Much of it is how it was when we bought it, and a lot of things now need repairing since we've moved in. Anyways, that's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it. I'm prioritising the doors to get the width of the room, and the length will be changed when all my main furniture is present. It may not be true to life, but I think it's better to prioritise fitting in matching furniture over the room measurements. I'm very pleased with the wallpaper in this room, very true to life, and a bonus that it comes with skirting boards. Understandably, for Ugly Sofa Gaming, the sofa needs to be right, so I spent time scrolling back and forth. I needed to find a balance between getting something the right shape and something the right colour. Honestly, considering the amount of packs I've got installed, I was quite disappointed with the outcome. Where are all the navy scatterback sofas? For some reason I go with this one, but change it much later on, after building the rest of the house. You'll see. The games console wouldn't fit inside the TV stand, so this will have to do. I am so pleased there is a cat tree. It's probably as important as the sofa, as this is one of Major's favourite places. It's a bit massive though, and prevented me from putting any pictures up on the wall behind it. I am very pleased with the lights. I'm not happy with the positioning of the chair, but there isn't much I can do about that due to the angles the game allows. This cupboard frustrated me. I guess because unless it's a fridge or a wardrobe, there isn't much use for a cupboard in The Sims, so there aren't many options. I settled on something that was similar in size and colour in the end, even though it was made up of multiple bits, I think it was the best option. Our wall behind the sofa has a shelf filled with various meaningful images and trinkets. I seriously struggled to replicate any of this in The Sims. I kept picking out items that I thought would work, but they were actually massive. So in the end, I went with pears. I decided they're the way to go. Not particularly meaningful, but they do look crisp and delicious. Also, my cow is now a cat. I put in a scouting trophy from the Seasons Pack 2, as I think if I had a trophy, it would be meaningful, so it suits the shelf. The wooden hand amused me, so I bought one in real life. I don't think it's too bad a mock-up overall, just don't look at the knickknacks too closely. I showed Lee the finished room and he questioned why we live this way. Bit harsh. In Dreams you can be incredibly accurate. You can individually sculpt every piece of furniture and every detail can match perfectly if you wish. However, every piece of detail you want to craft will add on extra time. And I'm certainly no expert when it comes to creation and sculpting, so for ease and speed, I'm going to be using community-made assets as much as possible and plonking them down sim style. Here I'm going to use a puppet for scale. As opposed to The Sims, your Dreams room can be any shape or size, so it's important to build it around a playable character if you plan on using it for something else later on. Currently, I have no plans to use this house for anything other than to look at, but you never know what might come up in the future, so I'm going to leave my options open. Because I was such a fan of the walls with built-in skirting boards, I'm just editing one that has already been made to suit my purposes. as with the Sims build, I'm going to be using patio doors for scale to figure out the width of the room. I couldn't find some that I like, so I managed to steal some off of someone else's house. One of the beauties of Dreams is that if something is shared as a remixable asset, you can go into it and break it up for parts. I had to edit these a lot more than I would have liked, but in the end I think they've turned out more accurate. To add windows, I added boxes onto a white panel for the frames and then cut it out using the same cuboid made a little smaller, and I used the glass that was provided with the doors. I could have added handles, but I've spent way too much time on these doors and the house will never be done if everything is going to be 100% accurate. Let's compare where we were in Sims after spending the same amount of time building. Already you can see an obvious advantage The Sims has over Dreams in terms of speed. I just spotted a door that may have been a better fit for the white one, but it was listed as a window, so I guess it may not have come up originally. This wooden door is pretty close. I haven't bothered to add in the grooves around the window panes, just wanted to make it passable. I've put this on the wall, but unlike Sims, Dreams doesn't automatically recognise it as you adding a door to the wall, so I need to cut out a hole for it. To do this, I'm scoping into the section of the wall and adding in a cube of nothing, and then stretching out the nothing to the size of the door. Cat tree! This is good enough for Major. For the television stand, I had to Frankenstein two different assets together. Definitely worked out more accurate, but at what cost?
Hello, Major. I was talking about you, not to you. Oh, sorry.
I'm now concerned about getting a matching cupboard by the door. Going to leave that until later, I think. In comes the PlayStation 5, scale seems true to life, but it does need to fit in the slot in the unit. The sofa. Again, disappointed by the selection actually, couldn't get one pre-made. This one has the basic shape and might work better than the Sims one actually, just need to go extra on the cushions. I thought about using a ready-made shelf, but realised that's probably unnecessary, as all I need is a black cuboid. Again, I could be accurate, like very accurate, with the pictures and knickknacks on the shelf, but I don't want to spend obscene amounts of time on it, and I worry if I import too many things from too many different creations, it'll break the game. At least there aren't any pictures of fruit. In Dreams, you must keep an eye on your thermometer. There is only so much graphic memory and detail you can include before it slows down, so the game puts a limit on how many shapes you can put in. At the moment we're fine because we haven't used that much of it, but I've just got to keep in mind that it's best to duplicate assets where possible to reduce the risk of capping. I could not find a similar enough light fitting. I stamp things into the scene as I go because I don't want to lose it if I have to come back to it. These lights are mostly made out of ribbons of paint that appear to be joined together due to some sort of effect. I have no idea what I'm doing with this, and honestly, it may have taken me all day if I was trying to go for an exact replication of my light fittings. I've settled for roundish and white. The fact that they poke through the walls may come back to bite me later on, especially if we try and put all the rooms in one scene. We'll see. Similar to The Sims, Dreams has a grid that you can change the size of. It makes it easier to place items accurately, but I often forget to turn it off, which makes things unnecessarily awkward to move. I start off with this stool for the side table. The legs are chunky, but they're at the right angles, so I thought it would make things easier. I've taken away the detail on the legs and changed the shape of the top and the colours. The owl lamp was made by making an owl glow. The cat tree was good enough, but couldn't resist tweaking this quickly to make it a tiny bit more accurate. lamp. So this cupboard was surprisingly easy to make. I didn't bother to search for one from pre-made assets because I wanted it to match the television stand. So I went straight to cloning the original and changing its shape and size. Actually, much less frustrating than messing with the modular furniture in The Sims. I'm just adding in a few final touches, ornaments, etc. But again, I don't want to overload this room as I want to be able to have enough memory left on my thermometer to be able to create a few more rooms. Otherwise, I'll need to tie multiple scenes together, which will mean loading when entering a new room. Dreams has a handy tool that allows you to see the detail amount of the items on screen by using a heat map. You can easily turn down the detail on things to save thermo, but you need to be very careful with how it makes things look. Less detail makes everything very fuzzy. The rug was made up of lots of tiny pieces that made it easier to recolour it. I recoloured it in sections selected at random using the fill tool. You may have noticed I didn't actually include a rug in the Sims build, but that's because I bought the rug in between that video and this build. Does that make sense? Dining room. I was dreading doing this room in The Sims because of the awkwardness of the stairs. I thought I'd have to make the room slightly bigger to accommodate straight stairs, which would put it out of proportion. I started building it this way until I came across this arrow. I am amazed by the stairs swivel tool. Game changing. I've had the game uninstalled for quite a while as it tends to suck away all of my time, so I probably missed the update that did this, but it's been a PC feature for at least 2 years, so I really need to get over it. I wasn't happy it wouldn't allow a picture above the stairs, and there wasn't one small enough to go above the door. However, this painting of marriage is actually perfect for our wedding photo. It is so easy to resize the rooms in The Sims 4. If there's stuff on the wall, it'll move forward with it, and if there's stuff in the way, it just goes into storage. I'm annoyed by the curtains, as I couldn't find a pair with a pole that goes all the way across that was in the right colour. The table and chairs don't match with each other, but neither do ours. They're pretty accurate, actually. And there's only space for 2 cat dishes, whereas we have 5 down usually. One of our cats is not going to be very happy. Overall, I'm happy with the outcome. The table and chairs are great, and I think the stairs have saved the day. I'm starting with the stairs because I think they're going to be tricky. I then decided to take a break from that to clone the walls from the living room and give them a coat of paint. I spent way too long trying to figure out how to spray one side of the object but leave the other side untouched. It's tricky because these walls are so thin, the spray paint tool goes right through them. These actually turned out well. Who knew the power of triangles for tidying things up? The doorframe I picked was too chunky to go back to back, so I used the stretch tool to shrink down the backside of one and then cloned it and flipped it so it could be sandwiched together. I painted the sideboard, but because of how it was made, I couldn't coat the top separately. I could have used the spray paint tool and avoided painting that part, but wanted to do it quickly, so I just added a new top instead. Rawr, our new wedding photo. I made a compromise on the table and chairs. I went with this set as it takes up less memory, but the chairs aren't like the ones we have in real life. I definitely prefer the Sims chairs, but I'm not convinced I'm going to get the whole house into one scene, so I'm going to need to make cutbacks. I would have preferred to get a window with a curtain attached, as unless a creator has made it as part of a set, you're unlikely to find a curtain to fit your window, as there's no standard size for anything in Dreams. Like in The Sims, there wasn't a good match for this corner cupboard, but in Dreams I was able to use a regular cupboard and cut off its bum so it fits snug in the corner. At this point I decided the room's too big, so I grabbed everything and brought it forwards. This is much easier in The Sims, as you don't need to worry about what's grouped together and what isn't. I need to make sure to duplicate assets from other rooms where possible. All hail Hypnotoad.
What? What's the matter?
The Den. So to enter our house, you need to come through 100 awkward doors designed to make life super fun when moving furniture in and out. Sims struggle with doors too, so they need lots of room to open and close, so I was worried about building this bit. We call this room Lee's den, because it's where he sits to get away from me. We actually decorated in here quite recently, making it a nice games room. Before it was just sort of an oddly shaped corridor where the bills were dumped. Shaping the diagonal walls at the back was no problem at all, and I was pleased I could have a beam running across the top. Again, disappointed by the curtains in this room, I couldn't find a suitable match. I couldn't find a suitable match for this custom fit desk we have. Makes me sad. I put a bug thing on the wall to represent the bird lamp, a random movie poster, and a nice white shelf. I did contemplate putting in a false wall, as part of this room is slightly more narrow and has a lower ceiling, but I didn't think I could pull it off, so I didn't get very far with that idea. These chairs are a great match. But I think this whole room is just the worst one so far in terms of accuracy. I think the desk just spoils the overall look. I didn't think this room was going to take so much time in Dreams, as it's quite small, but actually I had to spend a long time just on the walls. Painting it was a nightmare again. The walls I've used are quite thin, so it's not easy to spray, especially when the bright colours can bleed through so much. I spent a long time tidying up all the edges that overlap from the dining room too. And we have these awkward little false walls in the corners that I know I didn't get symmetrical, but they'll have to do. These wooden doors work great as window panels. Just had to make sure to remove any logic and stick them to something so they don't fall down, as they have built-in little hinges and a button press that will open the door when approached by a character. Copying across the door from the back to the front too, and just tweaking the size of the windows. We have big armchairs in this room, but I'm concerned about the graphics memory, so I'm just going to adapt a few things that are already in use to make some chairs. If I do manage to build the rest of downstairs and I have some memory left over, then maybe I'll swap these out. I couldn't find any suitable colour changing lights to go on the back wall, so I made some by stamping a couple of rectangles and sending a signal through it to randomly, continuously change the hue cycle of the light. As you can see, there's a massive amount of gadgets and logic in Dreams to experiment with. There are some really complex things you can learn to create, but these lights demonstrate the really simple stuff you can achieve too. I then made some blue cylinders glow for little spotlights. This is what we don't want to happen. I'm sure there are fancy ways to optimise the thermo. Maybe if this scene was used as a game, some things could be switched off in rooms the player isn't in, so they wouldn't always be included in the thermo count. Not sure if that works, but I don't know much about these methods, and for the purposes of this video, we do kind of want to just see everything at once. I'm duplicating these pictures again to keep the thermo down. I reused the TV and the table and took the bottom half of the dining room cabinet to use under the desk as little legs. I used the colour picker to choose the exact colour from the top to use on the shelves below. This shelf comes with bottles on it. As it's Lee's room, I'll treat him and let him keep one. I made an amazing discovery while making this room, a light fitting. This solves a problem. I went back and changed out my shoddy improvisations to this, as it didn't peek through the wall on the other side. A problem with Dreams is that it's up to the user who publishes the thing to add tags to make something searchable. I looked for light fitting and wall light, and this didn't come up. But when searching for sconces, here it is. Perhaps Dreams needs more categories within the elements section so you can find more of what you need in one place. For now, creators, please add lots and lots of keywords. I wouldn't have found this if I didn't go back in to look for a different light. I am so much happier with this version of the room than the Sims version. The lighting is fun, and there was so much desk disappointment in The Sims. Into the kitchen. I spent a very long time trying to get the right counters. Our kitchen units are cream on the bottom with a dark wooden countertop, and I wanted to prioritise the colour over the style on these. The style of ours are more traditional than modern, but I think these were the best fit. I also needed a style that included an over-the-top cupboard as well as an island unit in the set. We were really lucky when we bought this house, it actually came all in decent condition, so we haven't changed this at all. We have a hidden fridge under the counter which doesn't exist in The Sims, so if someone were to move in here, they may have a hunger issue. Actually, when we bought the house, we were told it came with a fridge, and we were very annoyed when we couldn't see it. It wasn't until a few days later that we found out it was integrated when unpacking kitchen stuff, so kind of felt a bit silly at that point, as we've been using mini fridges for a few days. We have a little whale on the wall of the downstairs toilet. He came with the house. He's now a cow, a whale of the land. This door leads to the garage, and this one to outside. I really hope these glass cupboards would fit in better so that I could have a combination of enclosed and windowed cupboards, but it was not to be, unfortunately. This room is much smaller and more awkward in real life, as we have trouble opening and closing the toilet door as the bar stalls are there. Also, yes, the door is all glass panes. Not a design choice we made, as I don't know why anyone would want to see someone peeing from the kitchen. Once again, the walls and floors look great, and so effortless to apply a pattern to a surface. Unlike Dreams. I'm not happy with the tiles on either the floor or the walls here. They just don't suit, but I settled, and they were easy to place and low in thermo cost. I didn't worry about lining up the floor perfectly here, as I knew there'd be kitchen counters plonked on top. Out of sight, out of mind. I was worried about finding the right units, as I had so much trouble in The Sims, and I knew in Dreams I'd probably be more limited on the pool of items, and I didn't want to have to build it myself. I was so pleased to find this set with a few tweaks to the colour and the scale. The counters were incredibly simple to place and came with detachable sides. Removing the sides made it quick to make an easy breakfast bar. I've pinched the window from the dining room and just cut out the wall around it. Again, just cloning assets already in use, so I can try and fit in as much detail into the scene as cloned objects take up less space on the thermo. For some reason, I found it really satisfying cutting out space in a wall for a window or a door, but when it came to shaving off the excess wall where it overlaps another part of the house, it really irritated me. I'm just pointing out a few kitchen appliances. We have a cupboard full of kitchen gadgets that we're gifted every Christmas, so there's usually something different on the side. Our newest gadget is a countertop electric pizza maker. It makes great pizza, but it's not a counter regular, so I'm not going to include it here. Something I stamped into the scene had a sky gadget attached, so I had to track that down to get all of the colours looking normal again. One of the problems with user-created content is that they can be shared with all sorts of hidden gadgets and extra bits that can affect the whole scene. And those gadgets could be hidden away and difficult to find at times. I had the warning come up on my graphics memory, so I used the heat map tool to reduce the details on the new additions. I then added the ceiling and some spotlights, tidied up a few edges, and thought this room will have to do. The garage is our laundry room slash workout room slash games room slash tool storage. There's a step down into it, which I didn't realize I could make so easily, so very happy with that. I don't have an actual garage door to put here, so I've used a garage mural from the City Living Pack. You can only see it from the outside though, so that's a shame. But at least we know it's there. I tried putting two back to back, but was rudely denied. We have appliances all the way along this wall. Actually, there should be a freezer here, but there isn't one, so I've put a dishwasher in its place. I don't have a pool table in my Sims stuff library, which I was surprised by, so I put table tennis in its place. It's green. It's a table, so it's basically the same, right? This random pipe represents the meter cupboards. We have lots of mood lighting in here for when we party with pool. Not a bad result, really. Got the general vibe and atmosphere in here, I think. So in Dreams, I'm starting with the floor. I put down a grey box and then cut some space for the lower level. Then I copied across a section of the stairs I used earlier. There was no way, no chance, I was going to spray paint the back of these walls to look like bricks. So I've added in a wall that someone else has made already. The appliances are great. This pack contains both a washer and a dryer, and the dryer makes noise and wobbles. I love it. The mini fridge has to do as a freezer too. I just turned it on its side as there isn't a chest freezer currently in Dreams, or I just can't find it. I did try a lot of search terms though. I knew there was going to be a great pool table, as John Beach, senior designer at Media Molecule, made a great looking pool room, which I think you can play pool in. I will probably need to turn down the details a lot on this though, because I'm running out. The window is straightforward. I added a box for the frame and then cut out a box for the pane. I copied the glass across from another window. Again, I'm copying the same images across to decorate the walls. I made my own strip light by making a shape glowy, like I did earlier with the spotlights. I may have to come back and add in storage boxes and books and things depending on how it goes with the thermo later on. As you can see, it is already bright red, so I'm a little worried as we still have the conservatory to fit into this scene. Onto the conservatory in the scene. The conservatory doesn't get used much. It's mostly a place for the cats to sit and look out proudly at their territory. The window and door frames are all red, but I wanted to get them to match, so I made them dark brown because the red was way too bright. We have the classic conservatory cane furniture, which doesn't exist in The Sims, sadly. So I use the next best thing, garden furniture. Our actual self is packed full of stuff and messy. The plants are not ripe, but are all massive for some reason, and I wanted a bunch of them there in that corner. Put a random assortment of whatnots on the wall. I have no idea how to use the roof tool, so I have to mess around with this a lot to figure out what I'm doing. I've also never made a glass roof before, so I was surprised to see it was even an option. Our roof is corrugated plastic, but that's not a thing. The greenhouse roof will have to do, as it explains why this room becomes an oven in the summer. Starting with the walls to get the overall shape, I'm not going to bother searching for windows here because it's going to be hard enough lining up the walls with the squiffy angles. That's not a good sign. No room in the budget for clutter by the looks of things, may even struggle to get chairs. I knew the walls would be a problem. To make it fit, I shrunk it down and resized the windows. That'll do. The carpet is black with a floral pattern, but I think I'm unlikely to find anything so specific, so I'm carpeting with this instead. The carpet is actually a nightmare for people with white cats. This window was frustrating. It's sort of the right shape, but it's too long. Actually, I think I may as well have remade it. I accidentally keep deleting things that I shouldn't do and have to undo all the work I've done afterwards. It is annoying. I think there's a lot of tiny details that could be achieved in Dreams if you have the patience, but with the thermo limits, there's no way these can even be attempted here. Like this wall. There are window ledges with things on that I just can't include. I used text boxes to glaze all the windows. I think I prefer this actually to the translucent paint effect I was using earlier. I was dreading doing the roof, but I actually enjoyed making it and I'm pleased with the outcome. That seems to be a theme actually. Why am I dreading doing stuff? I wasn't clever enough to figure out how to make the roof out of text boxes so it matched the windows, but actually I think this is probably better anyway, as the roof isn't clear. It's a translucent corrugated plastic and the paint strokes give it a bit of texture. It gets way too hot in this room in the summer. I wish I could just paint on a darker roof in real life and ta-da, new roof. Although the roof alone did take me an hour. I shouldn't become a roofer. I wasn't much good at it in The Sims either. Oh wow. I'm really not going to be able to fit much more into the scene. I don't want to have to figure out how to put blinds on the window, so I think I'll just stamp in someone else's garden to look at. This is nothing like my own garden, but it's better than staring into the void. In The Sims, you get the neighborhood setting, so it doesn't look so out of place. Now I've got a little bit of thermo to spare, I can add in some furniture in this room, I can resize the plants to fit the corner nicely, and I cut out a little hole in the wall for a cat flap. So now this is done, I have managed to spare a teeny bit of thermo for the chairs in the den. I'll update these as they're kind of a focal point for that room, so I think it's important. So we're heading upstairs. Upstairs is significantly smaller than down, as the house has been extended a lot on the ground floor, and the only alteration upstairs has been converting it from a 3-bedroom house to a 2-bedroom. By knocking out the partition between. I hate where the roof joins. I don't know how to fix this. Didn't Sims 3 have some sort of freeform roof tool? Wasn't there an auto roof? The small room at the front is kind of my art slash junk room. There's a little yellow chair that forms a single bed when pulled out, and the desk that I wish looked like this just isn't that nice. It's kind of falling apart. The room is a pale green with a light laminate. The doors upstairs all match the doors downstairs. Yes, including the bathroom. Again, not our choice. It turns out I don't really know the shape of my own house. All these rooms felt a bit wider, but I went outside and looked at the shape of the roof and realised that the top part really is small. I had real trouble fitting everything in here after realising the size. I did have little shelves on the wall, but they no longer fit. We have a little cat tree at the top of the stairs, which Melody likes. You have to gain her permission to go upstairs. The lights upstairs are similar to downstairs too. We have like a ball-shaped sconce in the bathroom. Closest thing I could find to it is this floodlight. So good luck to any Sims going to the bathroom in the middle of the night, as they're going to be blinded. Definitely need sunglasses for this room. The floor is a grey mosaic effect lino, and the walls are tiled, but kind of big tiles, just not as big as any of these. I'm glad we got a corner bath on The Sims. It's just not right, but it's a corner bath. Our counters are purple with black on top, but this is close enough. I'm sad there isn't a sink that just sits on top of the counter. I couldn't really find any suitable shelves to go around the room. And we have a big built-in cupboard that housed the boiler and the vacuums, towels and assorted bathroom thingamajigs. And I couldn't really replicate that, so this little guy will have to do. So the bedroom is grey with two scary red walls. We have matching dressing table, dresser, wardrobe and side tables, but none of the ones in The Sims actually go together for some reason. It's all a dark wood colour. I put in a full length mirror, as our wardrobe has three doors rather than two, and one of them has a long mirror. We did have two matching little lamps, but Lee swapped his for an ugly desk light. The gap at the top of the stairs was quite annoying. It wouldn't allow me to build the room right up to the stairs, as it threatened to delete them, so I had to make a small false wall. I have lots of bits of jewellery on the sides, but this wasn't possible, so I settled for makeup trays and nail polish as clutter. Can The Sims watch TV in bed in this version? I can't remember. I know in the old games they would just sort of stand in front of it if there wasn't a chair. Just a few final touches and I think we might be there. Oh yeah, I forgot about the roof. And we're done. So to make upstairs in Dreams, it has all got more complex, as I'm completely out of thermo. I need to make it in a different scene. If this was to be used as a game in future, rather than just the set it is now, these scenes would be linked together, so if the player were to wander upstairs, it would trigger a change to a new scene or level. To help with this transition, I have built part of the landing that can be seen from the midway point on the stairs to aid the flow of the scene change. I've duplicated the downstairs scene so that I have the basic structure of the building already. I have also deleted lots of stuff out of the rooms you won't see from upstairs, so I have some thermo left to play with. What I have left in is most of the kitchen, living room and conservatory, as they can all be seen from outside through the windows. And if I do go on to build the garden at a later date, I want to be able to use this version of the house to do it, as it has an upstairs floor. It would be weird if the house didn't have a second story or any furniture inside when looking in from outside. Does that make sense? For the sake of only a few walls, I'm not going to try the tedious spray painting all the way around. I'm just going to stick one wall inside the other and coat the whole thing at once. I used the lines on the floor to judge where my walls needed to go, as these show where the ceiling was changed and the walls upstairs line up with the walls downstairs. A tiny bit of annoying skinny wall painting, but not too much. I found a great tile for the bathroom that was the right shape and has some texture to it, which is nice. I made it a bit shinier and a bit whiter, and it works really well. So that's all the walls. Now the floors. I stretched out and fuzzied up a shape and made the colour match the stairs. Easy peasy matching carpet for the landing. For the bathroom, I found this amazing mosaic, which was massive, but when sized down was actually a really good fit for the room. I coated it to make it grey and it really works. There wasn't any skinny wood flooring for the bedrooms. I had to shrink down each individual plank so it didn't show through the ceiling of the rooms below. What an odd thing. Why is everyone making their floors so chunky? Anyway, the small bedroom floor is slightly lighter than the master room, so I have tinted them both a little bit too. So because I kept in a decent amount of downstairs, as I explained earlier, I quickly ran into thermo issues. So I prioritised getting on the windows so I could then make a copy of this version for the house to work on at a different time if I fancy. This version will be the external view of the house with the garden and drive and whatnot, because it has upstairs and windows. Now I've made a copy, I can go crazy deleting everything you can't see from upstairs. Lee says just to put curtains in and get rid of everything, but I want to be able to look out my bedroom window and see that conservatory roof I spent an hour making. Now I finished deleting, I can get back to decorating. I call this the rabbit room, as it's green with a meadow painting, pictures of rabbits and shelves full of Peter Rabbit ornaments I've inherited. It's a nice chill out space. This is the real test. Does Dreams have a corner bath? It does. But it's pokey like The Sims one. Ours almost goes from one side of the room to the other, so I'm stretching it out a bit. I also put a little seat in. I'm very proud of the way this turned out, actually. It also comes with a little bit of built-in logic, so if you were to press on it, it would fill with water. There wasn't a radiator type towel rail, so I used the one I used before downstairs. Plonk down a toilet. Put some boxing in next to the toilet just to hide the pretend pipework that isn't there. Found a roundish sink that would work on top of a counter. Our cupboard is actually curved, but I couldn't find anything suitable, so I've gone with square. Then I made a built-in boiler cupboard. It has a sliding door on the front, so I've made it half open so you can see some of the contents, all fancy-like. I did a bodge job on the shower to make it fit my taps. That thing would definitely leak, and I couldn't find any glass shelves to put stuff on, so decided to leave that. I couldn't find a bedroom set, so I chucked in a few different things and coated them all the same colour so they looked like they belonged together. Then I stuck together two wardrobes and copied across the mirror from the bathroom and resized it to make something that looks pretty accurate. I had to keep reminding myself to check with the man if it's the right size, so it all needed shrinking a bit. This is where one of our PlayStation 4s retired to. We gave the other one away to a friend to make her play Dreams. Still waiting for that to happen. you know who you are. I was lucky I found some curtains that sort of fit, and I used the fabric from these as lace for the doors. I made some wall art with these paintings, wheat chic. This desk was a pretty good starting point for my office corner. I just duplicated the bottom to make shelvings on the top. Shelvings? This very exciting looking chunk in the corner contains bedding. I'm just taking a few final bits of decoration from what's left of downstairs and reusing that. Now I've stretched out the ceiling to cover everything, I can add the ceiling light fittings, duplicated from downstairs, and some spotlights in the bathroom, made the same way as before, just a glowy circle. And we're done. Done. So let's wander around the house then. So I moved my Sim in at 11:04. The first thing she did was remove all of her clothing to shower in the rain and get zapped by lightning. 13 minutes after moving in. That's a new record. I thought she was going to die. As you can see, I've opted to go first person in The Sims to try and achieve a similar effect to the first person puppet in Dreams. Unfortunately, in The Sims, I couldn't get the movement to work so well. She seemed to refuse to go upstairs. One massive difference between designing in the two games is that if you design in The Sims, obviously then you have a home to play in The Sims. However, if you design in Dreams, you then have a home to play any game in. The catch is, of course, that you have to build that game yourself. Unless you convince someone else to do it for you. So you won't get that instant satisfaction of being able to jump straight in and play right after creation. But you do have endless gameplay options. Speaking of jumping right in, the first thing I did in The Sims is walk up to the house and realise, after 3.5 hours of creation, I'd actually forgot to put steps up to the house, so it wasn't possible to get in. I've never actually used first person mode in The Sims, so I didn't realise how boobsy it would be. Or how nauseating.
Mabiza Shibu!
So the total time it took to build the house in The Sims was 3 hours and 35 minutes. That's a long time for The Sims. I think it was because I was being overly picky with my furniture, maybe. And the total time it took to build the house in Dreams was 13 hours and 35 minutes. 10 hours more. 10 hours more. So the packs used in The Sims were Seasons, Cats and Dogs, Dream Home Decorator, Laundry Day, Industrial Loft Kit, Blooming Rooms Kit, City Living, Vampires, Discover University, and Cool Kitchen Stuff. That's a lot of packs. The Sims has cost a lot more overall due to the number of packs. However, due to this, there are numerous items available, which does make it easier to find furniture that best matches your needs. I think there were a lot more times when building in The Sims where I thought, that's a good enough match. However, in Dreams, there were a lot more moments where I thought, there really isn't anything good enough. I'll just tweak this and this and this. Saying that though, people are making and sharing new assets with the community day after day in Dreams. So the table I wanted for the living room that wasn't available then may be available now, and it's completely free. It may also be that the items I wanted were there all along and I just couldn't find them. In The Sims, everything is placed in the correct category by the publisher. You can search by function or by room, but in Dreams, you're at the mercy of the tags put on by the creators themselves. So things do take some finding. If you're a Dreams creator and you're watching this, please, please include a wide range of relevant tags. Think of all the things you can name an item and include them to make them searchable.
Kangaroo.
Who paints like this?
Shishubi. Narimo!
I feel that I used a wider range of items in The Sims simply due to the limitations to graphics memory within Dreams, which heavily influenced my design choices when thinking about what to place. Again, aside from cloning objects to reuse and reducing the detail, I have no idea how to keep the thermo down in Dreams. I'm not an expert, but I'm sure there are lots of tricks to learn in that department. To conclude, many of the details are a better match within Dreams, but The Sims gets the overall atmosphere within a fraction of the time. In terms of gameplay, in The Sims, you have The Sims. In Dreams, this could be literally anything. I mean, I could turn it into a pinball table if I wanted to. What are your thoughts? Which rooms are your favourite, and what platform are you most likely to use to make your own sets and scenes? Let me know in the comments below. Ugly Sofa Gaming posts new Dreams content every week. If you've enjoyed what you've seen here today, please give it a like and consider subscribing. Have a great day.